with the number of schools going to four-day weeks kept increasing, or in health or mental health, corrections, you know, our prisons are bursting at the seams, highways, transportation, 2 years of billion-dollar deficits in the legislature, trying to fill that hole with transportation money. And we don't need to move, number one, incarceration of females, and number two, incarceration rates overall. We don't have to move from number one to number 48 overnight, but we got to be bringing that needle down instead of up. We have got to improve the health of our children. It's not a bragging point to be number one in teen pregnancy. It is not a bragging point to be have health indicators that are, show that people are suffering.
You turned around, but it was standing room only back at the back. This is a tremendous turnout, and I think it's a precursor of the energy and interest that we have in this election year. So I'm thanking all of you in advance. You know what the stakes are. I truly believe that this is a watershed year. If we don't make changes this year, if we go deeper in the hole than we are already, then we'll have 49 other states saying, thank God we don't live in Oklahoma. That's not why I envisioned. That's not why I got into this race. I got into this race to make Oklahoma as good as it can possibly be. We have all the resources, all of the assets. We have people who want to work. We have everything in place to just soar into this century. All we need is the will in Oklahoma City to get it done.